figured, I haven't been on YouTube in a little bit, not for any reason, I've just been doing homework. So I figured that since I actually got something done, I will talk to you guys about it. So I don't know if you guys can tell, but I got lip filler. Yeah. So my lips right now are completely swollen. And I just got filler today. I got a little bit under one syringe, and I got it to define my lip line. And I had lip filler before, and I felt like it was settling right in the pout. When I smiled, it was really, really heavy here. So I got more filler to even this out. And I got filler on the bottom, but honestly, this is like, I don't really remember where she put it because I was closing my eyes. And this is obviously not a lot of filler on the bottom. At the top, it's like swollen, like my skin is really tight. My skin's hella tight. Let's start with the beginning. When I got on YouTube, I was looking like brown girls with lip filler, different things like that. I didn't really see a lot, so I was like, you know what? Maybe I'll make a video. It's a little embarrassing and revealing. Cause like, look at this. This is like bruising. Ooh, this is like a ball of filler. I need to massage that. That is like, you see that? It's like a ball. That's normal. That goes down. Like I said, so let's start from the beginning because there's always like specific questions. First things first, this is my second time getting filler. My first time I got it because I had very little top lip. You guys, on the journey of my healing process, like I said, this is day one. They look alarming. It looks like, to me, it looks like a tire, or I don't know. It's hella swollen. Like the top lip looks like it's trying to explode. It's bruising. So what I use and what the injector use as well is Aquaphor. That's gonna be your best friend. The first time I got my lips filled, they told me to get Aquaphor. So I already had some. That's good. I am drinking Arnica tea, and that, number one, it tastes great. I put a little honey in it, two bags. It's actually a really good tasting tea if you're into teas. And then on top of that, Arnica is a natural herb. It helps with bruising and inflammation and swelling. So I figured, since I actually seen some bruising, I didn't really have bruising the first time, I would definitely ingest like some Arnica. I don't have any topical Arnica, but I might get it if like my bruising gets worse or something tomorrow. But yeah, so I have that. I love that. So let's get into some facts. Number one, pain level. When I first got filler, it was super, 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 it was painful. Honestly, I was in pain. I went into the office and I actually called them before I made the appointment, and I let them know that I wanted to get numbed. They forgot, so they made my appointment without numbing. And basically, I needed to get numbed for an hour. You have to sit with their numbing cream on for an hour. So they were trying to like inject me. They were saying like inside of the product, the product that's inside of the syringe, it has a numbing agent inside of it. So once you feel the poke and they insert the needle in your lip, as the product pushes out, there is a numbing agent inside, and that will help numb. It's a no for me. I'm super pain sensitive. I do not like pain. It scares me. I don't know how I have these piercings, honestly. Or how I have tattoos, because I'm literally always terrified. I say that to say, though, I look so crazy. Like, I can't wait. You're gonna see when I'm like gonna be looking hella cute. My hair looks good, but I look fucking crazy. But anyways, the pain level the first time was crazy. The guy that I was dating at the time, I literally, like, he was so supportive. I literally held his hand the whole time, and not holding his hand just because, like, oh, you're a baby, you need to hold somebody's hand. It's more of like holding someone's hand, because you get to squeeze, like, the pressure that you're feeling, that pinch, you can, like, squeeze, and then you feel safe, like, with your partner or with a friend, whomever. So did that the first time. It was painful. The results I liked a lot, but I kind of did some research and kind of seen, like, how I would prefer my lips. Brings me to today. I found a girl on Instagram that I really want to see, because she got training from this dermatologist in Atlanta that I really want to get into, but her availability books up super quick. So this other girl I thought was next best thing. She trains with her, and I loved her work. Her books are also filled. So what I did was I hit her up and I asked her if I can get on her cancellation list on Instagram. Best thing I could ever did. I already had a hair appointment scheduled, and so she hit me up and was like, hey, you know, can I get you in? Can I get you in tomorrow at 10 a.m.? Like, I was literally in the bath, like, taking a bath, drinking wine. And when I seen that DM, I was like, yes. Yes. Yes, I can come in.
And when I seen that DM, I was like, yes. Yes, yes, I can come in.
Down there, and I asked her, I was like, do you guys have numbing? She was like, yes. I was like, okay. She was like, we offer two different types of numbing. And I was like, okay, cool. And I asked, you know, about the charge. So it is usually at a lot of different dermatology offices or medical centers, med spas. They do charge for numbing. The place that I went to is called Orangetwist, and the person who I seen, her name is Valerie, and she is a NP, I think, a nurse practitioner, and she loves what she does, so she's passionate, she's amazing. I actually love her energy, and she's very educational. Basically what we did was they put a topical numbing cream, which is like the most advanced, because I was really nervous again. And then they I got dental blockers. Because I knew that I wanted, like, my lips to be structured out, and that was going to require a little bit more needlework. So I knew that I needed to be, like, hella numb. So the dental blockers, after they do the topical, they let that sit for about 30 minutes. Then they go in and they take a needle that has a liquid, it's a liquid numbing agent. And they put, I guess, like, one or two shots here, one or two shots here, one or two. So, like, 3, 6, 9, 12 shots. And basically, it, like, all of your mouth is numb. Like, your jaw, it's, like, from jaw to jaw. Well, I wouldn't go that far. Like, mid-jaw to mid-jaw is completely numb. And even, like, some of my nose was numb. And so, once that sits in, there is a sting with that. But she uses, like, a little vibrating machine that she holds on the side of your lip. And then she injects the numbing agent, because that does burn. Luma last time. But we end up doing Juvederm, because I wanted my product to, like, really sit in my lips. Basically, I work out Monday through Friday, so my body metabolizes products really fast. And basically, with filler and Botox, what happens is how it dissolves and metabolizes into your bloodstream. And so if you work out or have a fast metabolism, it will metabolize faster. That means that it will it won't last as long. So I went in and I showed her what I wanted, and she pretty much gave me what I asked for. I mean, this is day one, so I can't judge how this actually is going to look from day one. It just does not work like that, honestly. But what I can say, I wanted more definition right in my Cupid's bow, because my natural lips, I don't have a Cupid's bow at all. And the first person that I went to get filler from, she gave me a filler right here, and it's still a little bit in there, as you can see. And then I wanted fullness around the rim, well, the bottom of my lip, and I wanted more volume. So I wanted more, like, lip, and I wanted a little bit of height from the side. It's really, really natural. Like, when I'm going to the side and my lips are super swollen, it doesn't even look as, like, it doesn't have a lot of protrusion as you would actually think.
Good morning. This is day two. I want you guys to see me directly after waking up. So yes, my voice is all groggy, whatever. haven't brushed my teeth, anything. Oh, some bruising. It's hella swollen. Hella swollen. I don't know if it feels normal. Yeah. Day two is crazy.
And we're back.
Just navigate through, so
it is day three. Today is Wednesday, March 17th. It is 5:14 p.m. Sorry, guys, I did not check in first thing in the morning because I had maintenance here. They're fixing a couple of things around here. And I had to jump out and go to Orange Theory, stuff like that. But this is a close-up of my lips 3 days in. And they're not hydrated right now, so I'm actually gonna add some Aquaphor to them. So I still have some bruising right here. It looks like there's a little bit of filler migration here. We'll see. I don't know. Kind of, it looks like there's like a dent here, but it could be the bruise showing. These are all bruises from injection points. I don't know yet, honestly, but this side is evening out. This side is a lot softer. This side still has a couple balls, a filler that I can fill. The bottom feels fine. Bottom feels normal. But yeah, this is day three. Well, petroleum jelly for sure is an emollient. I don't really know if Aquaphor is. I haven't read the ingredients, but they sit on top of the lips. They don't penetrate. So on an everyday basis, like, I don't even use that at all. I literally only have that for lip filler. I hate like greasy lips like this. This is disgusting. It's childish. So yeah, Monday through Thursday, I usually bum it out unless I do a little content. Other than that, I'm straight bummy. Like, bummy. Yes. So let me tell you guys what I got with errands. Oh, I have to update you guys. So I'm not drinking the Arnica tea right now because I ran out. I'm drinking turmeric glow because it helps with inflammation. And also, I just love turmeric. And this is my favorite cup. It's from Target. Brand alert. I ordered this bag. This is the Teffler medium size navy bag. I ordered this a couple weeks ago. And yeah, it is. But I do want to let you guys know, it's huge. Like, you see, I'm barely able to fit it all in the frame. This bag is huge. When I ordered the medium, it was the only one available, and I thought, like, okay, it's gonna be like a medium size bag. No, this is like an extra large bag. Like, I don't even feel comfortable carrying a bag this large in stores or doing errands. The bag is really cute. I like the bag. So I'm not blaming anything on the brand, the designer, anything like that. Literally, lifestyle-wise, this was the wrong size for me. I should have just stuck with getting the mini. So I'm going to get a mini in, I want like white, and I want like a bright purse for like spring. So maybe like a pink or something. But I know I want a white mini, maybe a black one, or a silver one. I know that I want like a mini. They're so cute. This, I've turned this into my homework bag. That's how big it is. My laptop fits in here, like my camera, everything can fit in here, and I'll still have room. Like I said, this is not giving it justice. Like, it's huge. Good morning, folks. So, I just got something to eat, which, yeah. But this is Thursday. Welcome back. I'm on the phone with my friends.
Wait, lay her fucking baby ears first.
I know. I was going to say I was going to ask you.
I'm coming to ask you.
Mm-mm. They told me to lay my baby hair down. Don't jump on the camera looking like alarm fist.
Oh, Ashley, you too. I understand you being very free, but you too free.
Okay, guys, I'll be back. I'm gonna lay my baby hairs down because my friends is bullying me. Lord, can I see your lips really quick? Got him. So we both got our lips done. Remember, guys, I was telling you guys, me and my friend went.
Oh my God.
We're kind of scared. We're kind of scared with the lips, honestly, because they're so freaking swollen. But they're going down. This is Thursday, March 28th. Wait, what do I be talking about? It's March 18th.
It's March
18th. March 18th. I feel like I'm missing like a piece of filler in my lip over here or something. I don't know. My microphone broke. Crazy. So I'm gonna try to just have that lingering.
So we're just gonna go to, like a strip club or something. I am not really feeling it tonight, so I want to have fun, but my body is just feeling fatigued and tired. So I'm just doing a very light makeup. On my lips. I just have lip gloss, a little bit of lip liner. Wait, I'm ready. What the heck? There's not my thing waiting on me. And then.
It ain't no motherfucking vlog. None of that shit. Go on. I'm
just playing. Say hello to my vlog.
What's poppin', this SNL Looch? You ever need to get wavy, no drip, come fuck with me. Wavy means that you about to tsunami that shit. Drip is just like little rain, droplets and shit like that. Like right now, this a little drip, this a little lightweight shit. But I'm really wavy though. Max beat flow, you feel me? You got the small details, you got Balenciaga, got a little Stan socks, you got the Gucci pants, right? Hemet Lane. ACW, it's a lot of designer going on.
Yeah, I'm just compromising.
Showing off.
Good morning, guys.
Not like that. Why would you say that?
It is day two in Miami. Last night we went to the office strip club.
He always
and now we are about to get ready to go to the beach. I'm gonna show you guys the view. I'm very hungry. I'm very thirsty. I'm ready to have a cocktail. By the way, I have Neutrogena sun tanning because I love getting bronzed while I'm out here in the sun. And then I also have a little bit of black girl sunscreen underneath my makeup. Even though we're trying to get bronzer, still like to protect the skin.